Here is my generator or power backup alternator, you can say, because this is producing AC power. And here is the generator part, just I'm going to show you. This is something 4 to 5 kilowatt, 7.5 kilowatt, it is written, the dynamo is. And here is the engine. This is a three cylinder engine, of course, as you can see. Here are the three plugs, wires, you can see, and this is dirt shoe engine. Problem with this one is it went very hot one day, and it was smelling. The engine oil was smelling actually, and we felt it. And then while we came, I found leaking water, leaking coolant from, and where it is leaking, I'm just going to show you. Here I'm going to fill in the coolant so that you will understand. So this is plain distilled water I'm going to fill in. So here is the leakage, you can see. This is a self-starter covering. Here is a self-starter, and here is this leakage, you can see. So this dead plug, actually, it went defective, as you can see, it is cracked from here, and it is leaking. So we are going to replace this dead plug, this rubber dead plug. We are replacing with a new one. I just brought this new one. This is good quality, and the existing one is a very bad quality. They just put it in because these people who are making such engines, generator sets, they are just about to make it running, and they are not taking any care of the client that it will run with him. So we are going to remove it, opening this Jubilee clip. Then I'm just removing it from, and coolant is of course coming off, so it's okay. It came off on the battery, it's okay. This was normal, this I expected actually. Okay, so the coolant should come, then we will make arrangement for this one. The arrangement is actually, what I'm doing is I'm not only trusting on the rubber dead plug, which it was, and it leaked, and the engine, eventually a catastrophe can happen, and the coolant will be leaked, and the catastrophe will happen, and the whole engine will burn. So something that's not a desired thing. It's very, very much bad. The problem with these people, which I just told a little time before, that they are not taking care. You can see here, this is the temperature switch, and the terminal is open. They did not bother to put anything over here to wire it. I mean, if this is a temperature switch, the function is, I will show you on the camera also, the testing of this switch. After a little while, I will show a little shoot how to test this. I test it, and it's working. So the way is, it is opened normally while the engine is in normal running, normal temperature, up to 90 degrees it is opened, and while it is crossing 90 degrees or something like that, I mean, this is in the coolant way. Here it is, the coolant pipe, you can see from the radiator. This is the engine, the outlet of the engine to the inlet of the radiator. So while, due to any reason, the temperature is going very, very much high, so this will short circuit. There will be short circuit created inside this switch, and the voltage over here, the current over here, will flow in some way like this. So this is a protection device which is working very well for such engines, but it should be, and they did not bother to connect it inside. And now we are going to correct this problem, and then later on we will connect this system also, which is of this system, this switch. We will connect some relay, and I will make the circuit. We'll show you in another video. So here I am just putting this dead plug, which is of course a branch of wood. You can see from here, I just cut it out. So this branch piece, I'm just going to hammer it in, because this pipe we are no more using. This is not, this was an option actually for that engine, where when it was in car or boat or something, but now it is not used. So I'm going to fix this wooden stopper in some way like this. Now it will not be leaking and it will be safe. And then further security I'm providing by putting this rubber whatever stopper, but it is a little bit bigger in size. So how we will manage for this is insulation tape. We will be turning insulation tape over here. Sometimes we will make it, but it's difficult to turn it over there. So I cut a piece of insulation tape and we'll try to bind it there. But it is a problem, you can see. Difficult situation with insulation tape. It's taking to itself. Anyhow, we will make some arrangement. So okay, now it become a little bit fat, so that it will support this plug. Yeah, now it's good, it's supporting. So okay, now I put it in. Now is the time to grab my screwdriver, put it on the jubilee club clamp. And tight it. We will tight it a little gently so that it will produce enough pressure on the pipe or hose. And we'll grab it gently, so something like that. The main water will be stopped by the, of course, by the wooden stopper or dead plug. So this one is, now you can see it's secured and hope it will work. I'm going to fill in the coolant again and the radiator. Okay, actually the purpose of this video is, as on my channel there are two more videos on the generator or alternator I put on another generator. So people response was very good, they were watching and they were taking help from those videos, and now you can see there is no more leakage. And of course it is not coming off. I'm giving too much force on, but it is not coming off and hope it will do. So this was the repair on the coolant system or cooling system on this generator machine. Hope this video will also work for people who are looking for such solution and their machines while they are in trouble. So keep on watching, stay tuned, subscribe and like. I will make another video on this safety system on this machine using this switch. I will make a safety system to shut down the ignition while it will get temperature due to any reason. So hope this video will serve its purpose. Thank you for watching. This temperature switch we are going to test, and if it will work, we will make our safety system safety off for this engine by using this switch. As this is the original switch, I just removed it from the engine, and for the testing purpose I removed it. Here is my setup, how to test it. I just put two wires, one is, you can see, this is on the continuity. Now it's out of limits, open, the switch is opened, and here is my thermometer. I'm going to show you the way. So now you can see this is something 90 degrees Celsius. You can see all of a sudden it climbed to 90 degrees Celsius. It's okay. Now in the boiling water or 100 degree or 90 degree Celsius, I'm going to put it in and you will listen to the continuity. Now you can see it is in, and it went to some two point some resistance. This switch is working. Now I'm going to put it off of this pan. So after a little time, while it went a little bit cool, the continuity went off.